Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look at the Java builder pattern versus constructors. When should we use the builder pattern? When is it cool to use? And when it's when is the regular constructor with all the arguments? When is that cool to use instead? And the right answer is actually both of them is actually pretty well used together. But that was a spoiler. So let us look at some code so I can show you what I actually mean right here. First of all. Yes. And let me just press this button right here to end up right here. So tonight I've created a Spring Boot project by pressing File, New Project right here. Then I chose Spring Initialize, I chose SDK 15, I chose the Grail, I ticked off Java version 15 here, and then I made sure that I used Spring Boot 2.4, and then I ticked off Lombok because this is also a lot about Lombok actually. Then I went to the Spring Web right here and added that also, and then I pressed next finish, ended up with this project right here. I created a spaceship right here. I annotated this with entity. Oh, I forgot two dependencies. Let me just do this again, sorry. So Spring Initializer 15, yes, and I chose 15 again here because I wanted to mix some database JPA into it. So I chose Lombok right here, I selected web. Then I also found the H2 database dependency, and I found the JPA, Spring Data JPA. I also added that, and then I pressed next finish. So we have a bit more modules tonight. This means that as soon as I start up my application, a H2 memory database will also be created, and when I stop my application, the H2 database will be deleted again. It will, so it only lives in memory. Then I created the spaceship right here. I annotated it with entity, I gave it an ID, and I said I wanted the ID to value to be generated. That means that I will set this to null, and then I can save it, and then I will get a value for the ID. Then I wanted to create a repository. This is extends cool repository right here. This is, so I'm using the Spring data repository right here to save some spaceships and then also to load them again. Then I create a REST controller. Maybe we want to create a REST endpoint where we return a spaceship. Maybe we don't want to do that. Maybe we do want to do that. Let us see what happens. First of all, let us create some magic to our spaceship. Because we're using Lombok, if I add data like I do now, then you probably have heard me say that we get all the getters and setters and hashcode into string, but you can actually see this for yourself if you make sure you press build the project. Then you can go up in the build folder up here. Then there's a folder named classes, and this is the main blah blah blah. And here we have a space. Here we have a space package right here. Then I can go in here and then I can press the spaceship.class, and then this is actually decompiled from the class file. Here we can see all the fields. We can also see here we have a default constructor that was just created for us. Okay, then we have some getters right here, get all the fields, and then we have some setters for all the fields. Okay, that is also cool. So that was just by annotating the add data. We can also see we have the equals method right here, and we can also see how they actually create this equals method. You can see all this code. You will have to write this yourself if you would create a good equals methods yourself. And it's quite a, you can see there's a lot of lines here from 58 and down to 116, right? So that's it's 58 lines of code right there that we just saved. And of course, we also saved the can equal and the hash code. And the hash code is also very important right here. You need to have a good hash code so you can actually index and put stuff correctly into maps if you want to do that. And then another thing, then we have the toString method also here. The hash code is also used in the equals method. That's actually the main reason why we have the hash code. Let me just show that. There must be hash code somewhere. Hash code. Okay, it's actually not used. We use all the fields in the equals method right there. That's okay. So that's actually it. We got a lot of code created for us auto-generated because we added this as add data right here. And we also have a constructor. I have created a test down here. so we can actually test what's going on. And here we have the spaceship. We use the default constructor. Then I set some fields right here. And then I save my spaceship right there. And then I fetch all the spaceships right here, and then I print them out. So quite a simple test. Let us just run it. And it's just to show that if you are dealing with just the default constructor at least, then we have many lines of code to show the same thing. Yeah, just to set all it. We have, need to have one line per property, per field that we want to set, per member variable. And here we have it, begin test, end test right there. And then we have ship in DB, spaceship, and it actually got an ID from the H2 database. It was assigned ID 1 right there. Pretty cool. But let us say that we actually wanted to create many more spaceships. Let's say we want to create 10 spaceships instead. Then we had to create one more like this, right? Create one more, and we actually, the captain is still Mike, still a captain of all these of these spaceships here. Then we have a cube, and how can he do that? You might ask, it's because he uses these spaceships one at a time for each weekday, maybe. So then we have spaceship 3 right here, and you can see all these lines of code here, and we're actually repeating ourselves a lot. We are setting Mike is the same. Actually, also the fuel level is also the same, because we know that when they come from the factory, then they're always filled up with 77.3% fuel, of course, in this situation here, right? So we have a lot of, what do we have, a cube, round, or ball. Ball shape spaceship, and so we actually have a lot of code here which is actually kind of the same, and that's where the builder pattern comes in, because now we can actually use the, and of course I should also save all of the spaceships right now, it's just the first spaceship that has been saved. Of course I need to save all of them right there. Instead of doing that, then we can actually annotate with builder, and let us see what happens now. Builder Lombok. Yes, we got a problem right now, and the first problem is that we got is actually that the default constructor is removed, and the scope is set to, it's not removed, but it is actually removed, and it is replaced with a constructor that has all of the member variables, and which is package protected instead. And I'll just show you that. So if I build the project again, maybe we should let us fix the errors here by just deleting everything right here, and I'll commenting this line right here. So I'll just press build, and if you go up in the Gradle folder, this is a Gradle folder, the build folder right here. IntelliJ also has its own version of the classes actually. Sometimes it's an it could be in an out folder, that depends on what it has been set up to. But right now here we have the spaceship class. Let us go up in the top right here. Let us see what actually happened right here. Look what actually happened here. Public static. We got access to a builder. That's what the first thing we actually got. So that means that we can actually call spaceship.builder, and then we will get this builder right here. And builder, spaceship builder, is then an internal class, which I will just show you right here. Here we have the static internal class right here. And if you haven't seen my video about how the builder pattern actually works, then I would also recommend you to see that. But the short story of that is actually that all of the fields is safe within the builder, and then when we are calling the fields through the builder, then these fields are set right here. And that means that when we then use the build method, then we create a new instance of the spaceship, as you can see right here, with all of the internal fields from the builder instead. And that means that we can actually reuse our builder multiple times. So I could create 10 spaceships and then only change the fields that I wanted to be changed. That is the cool part about the builder pattern. It also looks awesome, of course, in the code. So yes, that is actually it. Let me just find the constructor. So if we have I want to show you that the constructor is now not public anymore. It is protected. Let me just go up. Here it is. So instead of having a default constructor without any arguments, now we have all of the arguments. So it's only possible to create an instance if you have all of the arguments on the spaceship right here. And it is package protected, as you can also see. So yeah, so that's it. Let us try to use it now. Let us try to use it. So if we go down to the test again right here, let us just check out the difference. Then we have spaceship.save, and then we create a builder. Let us create a builder. So let us create a builder. So I say spaceship.builder, like this. And because we want multiple spaceships, then we can write builder. And then I can write captain. The captain is always Mike for these spaceships here, right? And that means and the fuel that was always was it like 70%, right? And what's the 72%? But it doesn't matter. But it's a fixed value in this situation right here. Then we have a model, and the model actually varies a bit. So pyramid right there. And instead of ending it up here, then I can actually write something like this, right? So now I've created a cool builder right here, and then I can just start by saving the spaceship right here, builder.built, and then a spaceship is created. Very, very cool. Then I can create some more spaceships. So let us say I want to create some more spaceships, then I can just write builder dot, and then we know it's only the model that changes right here, right? Then I'll just write round or ball or whatever I want to write right here. Model.model, and then we can write, what was this? This was a cube right here. So now I've created three spaceships from the model. This could be a flying saucer or something like that, the build. And it may be in this last one here. Maybe I'm not the captain right here. Then it's Susan instead. So now Susan is set as captain as the last ship. If I run this test right now, then I will get a new spaceship for each of these, and they would actually have these properties to start from. And it's much fewer lines. We save a lot of code by using the builder pattern like this. And it also it looks quite cool, right? When we are even if we just create one and have the build up here, then it still looks quite cool. The syntax, it's easy to read, I think. Let us run the test and see what happens now. Boom, boom, boom. Try stuff. We actually got an error. No default constructor for entity. Yeah. So we actually got a problem with we need actually when we are running this find all, then what JPA is actually doing. It actually tries to create a new instance of the spaceship, and then it tries to map all of the database columns to the fields, and it cannot do that because there's no default constructor. We can also see there's actually a red marking right here. You need to have a public NoArc constructor. So, and we can actually do that with Lombok also. We can just say write NoArc constructor. You have probably seen me write this a lot of times, and I've not really explained you why, but we need the NoArc constructor if we want JPA to map the columns in the from a table to the member variables of a class. Let us run again now after we have set NoArc constructor, and we should actually also go look at let me just check right here. Now we got another error. What does it say right here? No error constructor spaceship in class cannot be. Yes, okay, because now another thing is happening, and you have probably seen me add another annotation also if you've seen my other videos, but another thing is actually happening now, and it's quite funny. If you're a nerd like me, then you would actually find this a bit funny. If I go and look at the code, then I'll just show you something cool, because we set NoArc constructor. So that means that now Lombok would actually overwrite the behavior, and then it will actually set only the default constructor. And that means that we actually lost the constructor from the builder annotation. Let me just show you that. Okay, it can actually not compile at all right now. So we need to make sure that it can actually build first. So that means that if I run annotate this with all arcs constructed, this is the solution. And this is why in many of my videos, you will see me write no arcs constructor, all arcs constructor on top of the beans that we are using on top of the classes. So let us try again now. We press build again, let's see what happens. And now there's no problems because we have the all arguments constructor. We also have the no arcs constructor, and these will be made public by Lombok. So this is Lombok that actually handled these, and we can go look at the spaceship right here. And let us just check that we get that we have the constructors. Where's my constructors? Are they in the bottom? Well, oh, here it is. That is the builder. Yeah, here we have the constructors. The default constructor without any arguments. And then we have the all args constructor with all of the arguments. And we need those if when we need this constructor when we are dealing with the builder for a framework. And we need this constructor because we are using JPA, and also because we're using REST. That's actually why I added REST controller. We have the same problem with Jackson. When Jackson tries to convert an instance of a class into JSON, then it actually uses the other way around. Actually, it's actually the other way around. When it tries to convert JSON into an instance of a class, then it needs the default constructor. So let us say that we have a public string, and then we had receive spaceship like this. And then if we had a spaceship as an argument right here as the body spaceship, so that means that this should be posted as our body request body. So that is from the request body this comes, and then we can have like a post mapping, and then we can say spaceship. So when I post a spaceship to this endpoint right here, oh yes, of course I need to finish it. Return. Let me say thank you for, and then we can add the spaceship dot to string. Because what actually happens here is, we actually don't need to write to string. Because what actually happens right here is that JSON actually converts. It receives there's a JSON in the body, of course, but it converts it to a class. So if we have something like here, we also need the public. We need the default constructor also in this case right here. That's actually it. That's actually what I wanted to show you. If you wanted to create all of these spaceships here on startup, I've shown you how to do that a couple of times actually. But then you could actually create a class like this, something like on startup class like this, and you can annotate this with component. And then we could actually say public void on startup. And then we can annotate this with the Spring event listener, and then we can actually say on startup event or something like that. We have that somewhere on start event application started event, this one here, event. Then we can actually call some codes, and we can have another method right here, which is private void create stuff, because I want to call it the different ways. So that means that first of all, we need to wire our spaceship repository in, and we can do that by writing spaceship repository like this, spaceship repository. And because we make it final now, we can use Lombok to have required arg constructor right here. That means it will actually create a constructor for each required argument. And because this is final, then this will be seen as a required required argument. So this is pretty cool. And then here we can actually say create stuff like this. So that is one way to create all of it. We will not delete all of it because I want to show some funny things. Because we could also have another method which is on post construct. That means that after this instance of this class has been created, then Spring will actually call this code right here, public void post construct, and the name here doesn't matter, post construct code or something like that, right? Then we can just call create stuff like this. So now we'll actually have all of it created twice, and we can see that in our unit test if we don't delete all. And right now we should actually not create anything because it will be created by Spring itself. So let us run the test. Now we should have all the spaceships twice. Yes, here we have the old spaceships. We have 10 spaceships, and we actually only have created 5 different ones. but they just get new ideas. So we have the pyramid mic here, and then it starts all over right there. Well, it starts there, and then it starts all over once again right here. What is calling first? What will be calling first, you think, on post-construct or on the application started event? I know what I think, and of course I think that on post-construct will be called first. But again, Lombok comes to the rescue. We can actually ask Lombok, because if we annotate SLF for J right here, then we get logging for free. So that means right here, then we can actually say log.info post construct now. It's just so we, then we can see it in the, and again here, on started events occurred. Like this, and we can actually also, I think you can, we could actually have already seen it in the output, I think so, I'm not sure, but now we'll know for sure. So yes, so this is actually it. Here we got it, yeah, now that's the test. Let us see what we actually, oh, here we got it. Post construct right there. So that means that the unstarted has been created right there. And then we have unstarted events. So that means that here the application is up and running. And then we call all of that again. And then after that, when all of that has been called and the Spring Boot application is actually running, then our test is being run right here. So that is how it works. Yes. Thank you very much for watching. Let me just go back right here. First of all here. And second of all here. And as I said earlier, watch the watch my builder pattern video if you want to know more about the builder pattern. Join our Discord server. We have a lot of fun. We have music quizzes. We have funny jokes. There's of course also some discussions about technology and programming. Thank you very much for watching. Hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.